fortunate at the Mary Mitchell Center to be hosting this today. And although I'm up here, the Mary Mitchell Center is a team. We have some amazing board members and fabulous staff. We're doing two things today. We are going to go for a walk, but we're really launching our Bronx Healthy Neighborhoods platform. And we got the young people at the Mary Mitchell Center to help us do a visual to explain first, why do we need a health platform in the Bronx? Well, it's because the Bronx is not healthy. This is why we decided to create the Healthy Neighborhoods platform for the Bronx.
My name is Gustavo Rivera. I'm the state senator for the 33rd district, right here in the Bronx. I'm here at Mary Mitchell Community Center, as I have been many times before, because I know that Mary Mitchell, for the last 15 years as they've been here, they've been committed to making this community better a little bit every day. They have community programs, they have after-school programs, they have karate, they have dancing, but the most important part thing that they have is that they have a commitment to making the Bronx better. And today, what we're doing is having that part of the commitment that relates related to our health. We have some dancing going on in the back here. We have some education happening so that kids know what are the things that they need to do to be a little bit healthier. So I'm just very happy to be here working with the Mary Mitchell Community Center. And as long as they'll have me, I'll keep coming back and doing the same.
I'm Dr. Jane Bedell. I'm the Assistant Commissioner of the Bronx District Public Health Office of the New York City Department of Health and Mental Hygiene. My job and the job of my staff is to improve the health of the South Bronx. So we're happy to partner with groups like the Mary Mitchell Center, who have had a long-standing interest in health. And as some people may know, about two-thirds of people in the Bronx are either overweight or obese. And this really sets them up to get all kinds of poor health outcomes, diabetes, heart disease, even increased chance of cancer as a result of obesity and being overweight. So most people don't want it that way. How did that happen? It happened because the food choices and the physical activity choices out in the neighborhoods are kind of tough on people. I talk to people who tell me they go way out of their way to get fresh fruits and vegetables. So the health department is working so that it shouldn't be that way. It should be easy to get fresh fruits and vegetables. It should be easy to get healthy food. It should be easy to send your kids out and know that they're going to be safe in the park and that they're going to be able to run around like these kids are running around just on their own. So we partner with community organizations, help bring the data in, help work with people about what we know will improve health. And I would say most people are pretty interested in being healthy, being healthier, changing what they need to change in their families to promote health. And then we as a city have to make it easy for them to do that. The healthy choice should be the easy choice. You shouldn't have to be a hero or a saint, because these kids are our future and we've got to make them as healthy as possible.
My name is Sensei Will and I work here at the Mary Mitchell Family and Youth Center. I've been here for 13 years. 13 years ago I started a martial art program called Fight Back, which we started to get the youth in off the street, give them something else to do, build confidence and everything else. And since then it evolved into, you might as well say, like a global program. We're supported by the Loria Sports for Good Foundation, which is headed by Edwin Moses. And right now we're presently starting a youth council. What we want to do is take some good youth and replace the bad ones in the neighborhood. And matter of fact, the youth are the ones that's giving us walk today. Earlier I was talking to a couple of gentlemen, giving them a little history on our wall with all the graffiti. That started because of a shootout that happened right behind you. And Obama, President Obama, sent the drug czar here and everything, and they gave us the logo on the wall. And afterwards, one of the artists decided he was gonna get some of his international artists to come in like every 6 months and change the wall, you know, for the kids and everything. What we really wanna do is we wanna change the face of the neighborhood. You know, we've gotten a little better, but we wanna get even better. So, like I said, we're setting up a youth council. Once we work with them for about 6 months, they're gonna be going out in the neighborhood to try to bring in other youth and stuff to get them into something positive and everything, and to get them with any kind of help they need.
My name is Victor Pichardo. I am the Democratic nominee for the State Assembly, 86th Assembly District. And I just simply wanted to thank Heidi Hines and the Mary Mitchell Health Center for all the good work that they do. It doesn't matter where exactly you live in the Bronx, health issues and health outcomes affect our districts and affect our community on a pretty significant level. And we need to work with organizations like Mary Mitchell to make sure that we are able to beat back bad health outcomes and improve graduation rates for our young people, create jobs for our districts and our communities, and to help move our community forward.
Well, we're so glad everyone came to the Mary Mitchell Center today to help us launch our Healthy Bronx Neighborhoods platform, which is a way for us to work together between nonprofits to promote healthy behaviors for individual families, but also for all of us to change our neighborhoods so that they're healthier places to live and better places to raise our children. And today is just the beginning of a campaign to make our neighborhoods healthier. So part of what we're doing is a health walk. And so we're going to be walking in our neighborhood through the Crotona Park and back to the center to celebrate our own ability to make positive change, to make our neighborhoods healthier, and to work together to make sure that all of our kids are growing up safe and healthy.